Creative Commons developed the licenses which basically are the foundation of open educational resources. The licenses are there now, but Creative Commons is not done yet. So we have Cable Green with us. He's the director of open education at Creative Commons. Thank you for taking the time.
Thank you.
What's the status update from Creative Commons in 2018? You have some activities going on when it comes to open education. What's that?
So we have a few new things, I think, since you and I have talked last. One of them is two weeks ago, we launched our Creative Commons certificates. And so think of the certificates as a professional development opportunity to learn at the highest level of not only CC licenses, but the commons in general. So we have CC certificates for librarians and CC certificates for educators, which have already launched, in two versions. One is a 10-week online course, and one is a one-week boot camp with some online ahead of time. So there's two ways to take it. If you finish those courses and you pass the exams or the assessments, then you're CC certified. Our organization stands behind you in being an expert in that area. We also will, of course, because we're Creative Commons, make all of this available for free as OER under a CC BY license. And so if somebody wants to take these resources, modify them, remix them for other training purposes, they're welcome to do so. And that, of course, is available at no cost.
Second, you started the Open Education Platform.
We did. So part of our new Creative Commons network structure is this idea that what we were lacking before was a space, international spaces, to have conversations and work on projects together. And so we have these spaces we call platforms for open education, copyright reform, community development, and GLAM, which is galleries, libraries, archives, and museums. The Open Education Platform is now, I think we have over 70 countries, 740 people around the world. And the idea is that we will only work on projects that everybody needs. And we're going to limit our scope to content, practices, and policy in open education, which I realize is still a pretty big scope. But it has to be either an OER project or a practices project or a policy project that not just one country needs, but that everybody needs.
Who should join the platform and how to?
So easy to join, and it's free to join. There's no membership fees, nor are there any membership fees to join the CC network if people want to join. To join, simply just go to your favorite search engine, type in Creative Commons Open Education Platform. The first hit will be a blog post, and it tells you how to sign up. Who should join? I would say, you know, anybody that is that works in open education who is interested in having international conversations about things that we all need.
So it's not just another mailing list with a newsletter or something, but it's for people who want to get, I don't know, involved.
That's right.
In it's discussions.
It's for people who want to learn what others are doing, adopt those practices and content locally. But mostly it's for doers. It's for people who actually want to build stuff together and then build things that we all need.
Another thing, I don't know if this is a preview on 2018 or maybe 19, is Ryan Merkley told us about the registry for Creative Commons licensed content. How's this going on?
Yeah, so that's our new CC Search project. So today, CC Search is really a federated search of multiple spaces, and that's not really good enough. Creative Commons has asked the big search engines for years if they would please index the commons, and they won't do it. It's too small for them. It's not something they can monetize. They're not interested in it. So we're doing it. And the registry you referred to, what we're building is an index of the commons. So what's everything in the public domain and everything that has a Creative Commons license on it. And we'll have a database of where those things are. And then there'll be an open API to that database. We'll use that to build CC Search, but we'll also expose that open API to anybody else in the world that wants to build services on top of a commons index.
So this may not be a big project for Google, but I think for everyone else, it's huge, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a big deal because this will be a one-stop shop for finding openly licensed resources or resources that are already in the public domain.
Anything else we should learn about what's going on at Creative Commons?
Maybe just one more word about the CC network. Creative Commons network has been around since 2001. We kind of dissolved the old network, if you will, last year, and we're asking people to re-sign up. And the real purpose of the new network structure is to to be much more inclusive and to be, frankly, much larger. So the Creative Commons Network before was maybe 500-600 people. And the CC Network, we mean for it to be tens of thousands of people. And so we're eager for people to both sign up as individual members, if you'd like to be, and also as institutions, if they'd like to be associated with Creative Commons.
Just perfect. Thank you for the interview. All the best for your work. And we'll talk again 2019, maybe earlier.
I look forward to it.
Thank you.
Thanks.